Yeah, so hello everyone, and welcome to this session on Open Telemetry for Developers. Today I'll be talking on how you can use the open source toolkit Open Telemetry to know how well or how badly your application is performing. And this doesn't matter if you're a developer or you're a member of management. Anyone that wants to actually gain insights into the application, I think Open Telemetry is the way to go for free too. Yeah. So to our agenda, I will tell us about what Open Telemetry is, the players involved in the ecosystem. I would also give a broad level overview of the different data sources you can use to collect data if you're interested in getting data from your application using Open Telemetry. I also mention a simple application which would also have an overview of how we could instrument it if we're using a PHP library like the Open Telemetry and PHP package. And also, lastly, I'll talk about how anyone can get involved contributing to Open Telemetry. Yeah. So about me, I am a computer science student at Imo State University. I am also a software engineer with Patricia. Currently, I'm a CNCF and Linux Foundation mentee with Open Telemetry. I'm also a cloud native enthusiast. You can check me out on Twitter with the handle @OwnBC. I'm looking forward to interacting with you after this session on questions you have or probably ideas you have. So for starters, what is Open Telemetry? So a general overview, Open Telemetry helps us get insights into our application. So it's a collection of tools, APIs, and SDKs that we can use to instrument, generate, collect, and export data from within your application. This data you can use for analysis, you can use for problem finding, you can use for tracing, you can use for whatever insights you want to gain from your application. So aside being a one point for getting information from your application, the Open Telemetry project also seeks to be a vendor agnostic and standard for everything Open Telemetry. Yeah, so we have the specifications worked upon by the biggest player in telemetry industry, trying to like have one standard for telemetry. Open Telemetry is also a CNCF sandbox project, and it came to be a few years ago when Open Tracing and Open Census projects are merged together.
Sorry to cut you short. NWC, can you maybe widen up your screen a little bit? It's a bit like your screen. Probably maybe you could share.
So what can you see? Can you see two parts of my screen or one part?
Just one part, basically. And it's getting smaller and smaller.
Wow. Let me see what I can do.
Okay.
Probably I could try resharing. Do you think that could make it better?
Yes, maybe you could try and share.
Is it better now, or is it still the same?
It's much better now, but the presentation or the slides is in two screens, basically, so.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Let me see how I can undo this now.
Awesome. Perfect.
Yeah, so sorry for the inconvenience, but I hope you had everything I've said before now.
Yes. Your audio is good.
Okay, so in terms of the ecosystem, the Open Telemetry project is actually one of the most contributed to projects on CNCF, just after Kubernetes, and it has language support for both Go, Ruby, and lots of other languages. So as regards community support, we have support out of the box from cloud providers like Azure, GCP, and Amazon Web Services. So if you're on any of these platforms, you can easily get OpenTelemetry out of the box. We also have some vendors that allow you to both instrument and export your telemetry data to their backends. We have Datadog, Dynatrace, Honeycomb, Lightstep, and all of that, definitely for a fee. And also, we also have some persons who use OpenTelemetry as part of the application toolkit. We have MailChimp, Shopify, and Zillow. OpenTelemetry also collaborates with other projects, both within and outside of the CNCF ecosystem. Projects like Jega, Prometheus, and Kubernetes. So all these projects are around cloud-native technology, instrumentation, visualization, and all of that. So now let's look at a sample architecture for OpenTelemetry. So OpenTelemetry basically looks at three things. It looks at traces, it looks at metrics, and it looks at log. So someone might be asking, what is traces? So if you have a distributed system, a trace simply tells you the life cycle of your request from the start to the endpoint. So let's say you have a microservice for probably an e-commerce website. Definitely, you might have services around payments, services around stock, services around delivery. Those represent the different services you have, and the traces simply will give you information around those individual services. So aside traces giving us the information and the context around those services, we also have metrics. Metrics refer to things we can measure. For example, how much traffic is getting to our system, and all of that. This can help us probably scale our server or to automate some of the processes. And aside from that, we also have the log. So the log is anything that is not covered with either your trace or your metrics. So the example architecture is, if you have an application you want to instrument, you have an entry point. So the OpenTelemetry package provides two things for us. One, it provides an API, an application programming interface, which you can use to interact with the SDK. So the SDK basically performs all the operations we need, while the API is in charge of interacting with the SDK to give us information to carry out transactions underneath the hood. Interact with the APK, with the API, get data from the SDK. We go ahead and export that data using any of our visualization tools. We could use Prometheus, we could use Zipkin, or we could use Jaeger, depending on anyone you prefer. And since OpenTelemetry is vendor agnostic and packet agnostic, you can export to any of that without having any worries. We have support for all of that. So instrumentation, how can you get insights from your application? If you have a distributed system, how can you get insights? There are basically two ways. You could go the manual route, or you could go the automatic route. So for the manual route, you have to get any of the packages that we have for different languages. Then probably you install the package and go ahead to instrument the behavior you want using the APIs. If you have lots of endpoints, if you have lots of behavior, this can be a little bit tedious. So there is also automatic instrumentation where you use an agent. So what the agent does is, the agent simply goes to the core of your application, sits there, then retrieves every request and response, then exports it to any of our visualizers. From there, we can be able to compare, to make analysis, and see what we can do. So sometimes too, we can combine both manual and automatic instrumentation. So currently, I think it's only the Java project that has automatic instrumentation. For others, we just have manual instrumentation, but all of these are moving towards having something automatic. So you can be able to get insights from your application without doing much of the coding, just by plugging in the agent that we are using. So let's talk about a manual instrumentation example. Let's say you have a Laravel application which you want to instrument with the OpenTelemetry PHP library. How would you go about that? So first things first, you have to create a Laravel application using the necessary commands. then you go ahead and you require the OpenTelemetry PHP package. So definitely when you instrument your application using the APIs and the SDKs, which the package gives you by default, you need a way to see the data you're exporting. So you can actually bundle Zeppelin, Jaeger, Grafana, or any other tool that you like, or maybe even you can export to any other backend. Then you go ahead and you instrument the applications with your preferred APIs. Then since you've bundled the visualizers, you can also go ahead and see your expected data, whether it's your log, whether it's your metrics, or is your trace. So there's a guide there. We don't have time, so there won't be any time for demo. But if you follow this link, you'll be able to see how we implemented a sample Laravel applications, and we are able to get data about the application. So this is how visualizing data from your application looks like if you instrument with the OpenTelemetry PHP package and other packages too. We are able to see your spans, you're able to see your traces, you're able to see your logs, you're able to see timestamps. So let's say a request is taking 1 minute. You can actually go and see which request is that. You can actually see from which of your microservices. Then you can help debug all of that and make the whole process better. Yeah. So finally, I would also want to tell us about contributions to OpenTelemetry, because the language, the project features different languages, different frameworks, and different experience levels. So no matter the language you write, there's something for you in OpenTelemetry, no matter the framework, and no matter the experience level. And currently, most of the projects on OpenTelemetry are in beta. Only a few have reached general availability. So there is still a lot of work to be done. Also, as the last speaker mentioned, the different projects with OpenTelemetry offer mentorship. So if you're looking to get mentored, you can check out the CNCF mentorship repo on GitHub. So frankly, I think the OpenTelemetry project is actually very, very important. And we can see this by the fact that almost every cloud vendor supports it, and they are actually working to have a standard specs. So I think persons from Africa should actually come around. We have stuff for docs, we have stuff for code, for design. And if you're looking to get started, you can always reach out to me on Twitter. I'll be very happy to show you the way around so you can start contributing. So some resources, I have some resources if you want to look at distributed tracing for dummies. You want to look at the data sources we have for OpenTelemetry, or probably you want to see the stats around OpenTelemetry in the CNCF ecosystem. Yeah, so that's it. That is just the oversight of how you can get insights for an application using the OpenTelemetry project. Yeah. Yeah, Obasi, did you hear me?
Awesome. Yeah, I could hear you. Nice. Thanks a lot for the presentation. Do you plan on?
No. There's no demo for this.
Oh, nice. Cool. Thanks a lot for the awesome presentation, and we see. If you can also share your slides to the attendees, that would be very much appreciated as well. This is the Q&A session. This is the time for Q&A. If you have any questions from the BC, please feel free to drop it on the chat section, and the BC will be happy to answer any questions you might have. Maybe we could give maybe like a minute and see if everyone drops some questions. And if you are also streaming on YouTube, please feel free to also ask your questions on the YouTube live chat, and we'll be happy to answer any of your questions as well.